Hello everyone, it's Beef here. This is another one of these chit-chat videos where I kind of talk about something which I want to get off my chest in DayZ. Now this one is going to focus mainly on DayZ and looting. Now you'll know that looting forms a major component of this game. We all spend most of our time travelling around the map gathering loot, whether that be clothes, items, ammo, guns, backpacks, etc. The main driving force in this game is to find the loot you need to either A, survive, or B, PvP, or C, a combination of both, or whatever the hell you want to do in the game, but the key point is you need to get loot. That makes the looting in this game so important to get right. Now, looting has come a very long way since the mod days, and even from early DayZ standalone days. It's now handled very differently. So now we have the central loot economy, which is a good step forward in the right direction. I'm not going to get into the finer details of the central loot economy, but I want to talk about some of the things which are good at the moment and some of the things which really need some work and my ideas on how things should be changed or amended. So a couple of the good things. I think the map extensions and the way the map has been developed has been fantastic for looting. As we know, the mod didn't really have many enterable buildings for loot, which really restricted that element of the gameplay. Some say for good or some say for worse, but I'm not going to get into that discussion. We now have almost every building enterable, and I'll go on to this a little bit later, but almost all having loot of some sorts available. And I think that's great, and all the towns they developed in the north of the map are fab. That's great for more exploration and more looting. The recent 0.61 spread of military bases around the map, I'm broadly in support of. Moschino got nerfed down to a couple of tents. Northwest Airfield tents got reduced a little bit, but Tissy tents got added in, and we got Kamensk military base getting expanded, plus all the little bases. Now these little smaller military outpost bases, these should mainly be for picking up some little bits and bobs before you head off to get your main items, so I'm not terribly against maybe picking up an AK-74U or some other kind of mid-tier, bottom-tier guns at these bases. But I think they should mainly be for picking up the odd mags, some bits of ammo, some military clothing, maybe some military bags, some other kind of decent stuff which will allow you to hit up the large military bases and hit the ground running when you maybe pick up an AKM and you've already found an AKM mag. Now, the main focus is I want to talk about the issues at the moment. Now, one of the main things that's been noticed over the last couple of patches actually has been the clustering of loot. Now, the devs managed to sort out a large portion of clustering with regards to, say, for instance, the small grandma's gun house, I think some people call it. There would be occasions where there would be like six Winchesters all in one corner. I think they've more or less nailed that, but the kind of clustering I'm talking about is loot clustering in specific areas. If you go up to the northwestern town, Sinistock, I've been there on a couple of servers now. It's like fucking the IRA was living there or something. There's balaclavas in almost every single house. If you're looking for a balaclava, that is the area to go. We all are probably well aware of things like Balota. The town there would spawn a stupid amount of rifles and pistols, and in 0.60 the town Ratno and the supermarket out by Kamenka, you can get lots of bags and rifles out there. Now I don't know if this is an issue with regarding how the central economy functions at the moment, and those were kind of areas just by chance that were congregating these items, but I think there's a deeper problem here that needs to be looked at. I think currently the cars in the evacuation posts round about the Lopatino Moschino one, the one down at Kamenka, and there's also a big line of cars just as you head near TC Town. I think these are lovely, these are great, but they're spawning far too much loot just now, which I think is possibly dragging loot away from other locations, which we'll need to keep an eye on. You can basically go to these evacuation posts and probably find what, on occasion I've found 6-7 Winchesters and carbines, quite often a few of them with scopes. Now, scopes spawning on rifles such as trumpets and sporters down in places like Belota, that's another issue that needs to be resolved. We can't have all the hunting scopes congregating in one area. People need to feel like they can travel the map and find loot. It's very important. Now I want to come on to another main point here. As you'll see in the background, this is some footage from today of me running through the Northwest airfield. This is not an uncommon thing just now. I've been through the Northwest airfield maybe 3 or 4 times on this patch. And the majority of times, this is what it's like, devoid of all loot. Now, on Reddit, I used to have chats with people and I would kind of come down the side of being quite happy that there wasn't tons and tons of military loot all over the Northwest airfield. I still stand by that point. I don't want to be able to run there and find tons of guns, tons of mags, tons of vests, and that's you geared up, and then what else do you do? Go around murdering people. I think it's good that it takes time to find military loot. And I think obviously it needs tweaked with balance. I searched the whole of South Compound, the barracks over the other side on the east side of the airfield, all the hangars, all the barracks on the way up north, and all the tents. The only place I didn't go was over to the western Quonset hut and the little barracks over there. But in that whole visit, I found one AKM, one mag, another mag with a couple of little bullets in it, and some 9mm. Now, I think this is a little low. I'd like to have found some vests, maybe some more useful attachments for guns, maybe a scope or something like that. But I think a little bit of tweaking could be there. The main issue I had, and the main motivational or demotivational thing that I want to talk about, is you can go to these places and you can search a huge area and find nothing whatsoever. Things like the hangars, they're almost completely devoid of all loot. Just now, very, very occasionally, you may find something inside them. The barracks are generally devoid of loot. Very, very rarely you'll find something in barracks. Now, I want to be clear here. I don't want it filled with military loot. I think what I'm suggesting here is it needs to be filled with trash loot. Players need to arrive at an area and see things to loot, whether they be useful or not useful at all. Things like, I mean, we need trash loot, things like unusable plastic bottles that have got holes in them, or spent ammo casing, bits of old money, pieces of broken wood, broken pots, pans, bottles, pieces of useless pipes and metal. There's so much different types of trash loot that you could have spawning. Now, it doesn't need to be overflowing with trash loot, but players need to arrive somewhere and see that there is loot. And within that loot, there might be a chance of something valuable to them spawning in that loot. I don't want to search 6, 7, 8 hangars and not find a single thing inside them. I don't want to search 5 or 6 different barracks with nothing inside them. I want to go in, have a look around, have to look under bed and go, oh, what's that? What is it? Maybe it's something interesting. No, it's just a bit of shit. But that's fine. That's what I want. In normal MMO games, things like World of Warcraft or Fallout 4, I know that's not an MMO, but you know what I mean, RPG type games, bosses and mobs always drop loot. It's just that it's very rarely the loot that you need, and it's very rare to find top tier great loot. But the point is that this kind of loot system always keeps you coming back again and again and again in the hope that the boss or the mobs will drop something that you need. If an area in DayZ is completely devoid of loot and you go there once and it's devoid of loot, you might go back again and it's devoid of loot, maybe even a third time, but then you'll stop going back. And maybe that's by design, maybe that's what the developers want, maybe they want you to stop going to these areas. I don't understand why, because this is the whole point of the game, is to go to these high risk, high reward areas, get into interactions, gunfights, whatever the hell you want. this is where the contact happens. But if you continue to go here and there's nothing at all, you'll stop going. Now in Fallout 4 there's lots and lots of trash loot, and what we would do with trash loot would be quite interesting in DayZ. Obviously in these kind of games you can collect this trash loot and you can break it down into materials to build other things. Now that's maybe an option that we could think of. What could we do with the trash loot in DayZ? Would we take it down, maybe melt down some metal, build things like gates or walls or pieces of metal for our bases? That might be quite interesting. So you could collect the trash loot, or you maybe you don't collect the trash loot and you just leave it there. There's various options. I think there has to be a change in the way loot is handled. So another major issue I want to talk about is the buildings that things are spawning in. There's an issue with the central loot economy here, as we know. It's still under iteration, but I've not seen any positive work towards this lately, and I've not heard a lot of people talking about it. In the old loot system, there used to be certain key buildings which you would go to try and get some good loot. Things like corner pubs, piano houses, green and red mansions, construction sites, those machine houses which look like piano buildings but I've got the extra kind of lathes and things attached to it, tech buildings, the old office building, fire stations, Novo and Cherno towers, like the high schools even, the red brick buildings. So these were buildings that you used to go and visit in order to get gear. Now when they introduced the central loot economy, I kind of agree with this. It meant that loot was spread around all buildings equally, so it's because what people were doing was that they were going to these buildings and then ignoring all the other houses or other buildings in their looting paths. And I think it's swung too far in the opposite direction now, where everybody's just checking a couple of different kinds of houses and ignoring most of these buildings because generally they're shit. I can't remember the last time I went into a corner pub and found something useful. Piano houses, occasionally you might find a little thing down the bottom in the bookshelf, but upstairs, it's shit, there's nothing. Green and red mansions, we've got a couple of jackets will maybe spawn in one of the back rooms, a couple of bandanas, things like that will spawn, but generally it's shit. Construction sites, utter shit. There's nothing that spawns in there that's useful anymore. I used to love going in construction sites and looking for stuff. The machine houses, the piano houses with the lathes and things, crap, utter crap. There's nothing in there. The fire station is another building we used to go. The fire station's not too bad actually. The fire station has some firefighting gears and some taxis, but I would like to see maybe a couple of pistols and some guns have the chance of spawning in there to make people go there more. Because unless I want to dress up like a fucking firefighter, then I'm not really going anywhere near that. It's not so bad in this patch where you can pick up a jacket earlier on, it's getting lots of nice slots. But unless I'm RPing, I stay away from fire stations. The bus garages, they used to be quite good in older patches, but they're gash now, they're absolutely rubbish. Novo and Cherno Tower, there's fuck all in these towers. Why do we have all these fantastic buildings with absolutely nothing in them? The new high school, obviously somebody spent a huge amount of time designing this building, it's fucking empty. All these new industrial buildings they built and put so much time into, nothing. Shit. You'll find a bit of lime and maybe some burlap sacks in there, that's it. We've got the boat, Riffy. When I first started playing, I used to love going to this boat. Now, obviously, it would be a bit dangerous with desync and you would die quite a bit, but you used to be able to find some bits and things in there. Riffy is a fantastic bit of the game that it's a lovely designed object. It's a setting, it's a key bit to go and explore. It's not worth going anymore. You maybe find a shitty backpack, some bits and bobs of clothing. It's shit. All the time you spend looking in there is a waste of time. You may as well just go to a small town, look in a couple of crappy little houses and you'll find stuff straight away. These key buildings of DayZ are what made DayZ fantastic to me. These specific buildings where you'd end up trapping people inside, getting into altercations with, meeting people, going in and out of, it doesn't exist anymore. Loot should spread around evenly throughout these buildings, but these key DayZ buildings should maybe have a slightly higher chance of spawning good items like ammo, pistols, guns, in order to make you visit these items again and make them worthwhile. I actually quite like the way certain buildings have been designated as industrial, and you find industrial things in there. I quite like that. And I like how the medical centres, the blue medical centres, spawn kind of medical gear. But you've got things like the supermarkets. They're generally shit. There's generally nothing in them. The other thing that kind of infuriates me is the devs will spend a long time developing new buildings, which are absolutely brilliant. They're so lovely, they're so detailed. I love the new buildings that they design, but then they'll push them out onto a build, and they won't put spawn points into them. That means when we have huge long durations between builds getting pushed out to stable, you've got these lovely buildings which I will go to once and go, oh, look at the lovely new building, isn't it wonderful in here, it's gorgeous. And then never return because there's no spawn points and nothing spawns in it. I mean, that is just, that is insanity. Now, Prison Island, I want to touch on Prison Island slightly. Another huge endeavour that people made developing Prison Island. It's a fantastic location. It's a bit of a bitch to get out to, but it's a fun little thing to do now and again. And the last couple of patches, it's been a joke. It's been a disaster. At the moment, I've been out to Prison Island 2 or 3 times in this patch, and there's absolutely fuck all there. I've searched every single prison building cell, and you'll find a couple of bits of prisoners' clothing. The barracks generally has nothing in it, and you may be lucky and find a backpack, but it's a waste of time going to. I mean, that is an investment of maybe an hour of your time or 45 minutes of your time to get ready to swim out there, to spend your time looting it all and then swim all the way back. And what's the point of designing these fantastic areas and fantastic buildings and fantastic structures if it's a complete waste of time going? So, in order to finish out this video, I know it's been a bit of a rant, a bit of a ramble, but I want to talk about more options for how we do looting. I would like to see more dynamic options. At the moment, we've got dynamic police car crashes, and we've got dynamic chopper crashes. Now, these need work, and I'm sure they will get some work on. Chopper crashes are a bit shit. I personally would like to see them dynamically fly through the sky and crash, and I know the devs don't want this, but I think that would add so much more to the game. It would mean that within a kilometre or two, you would actually see a chopper flying across the sky. Everybody in that area is going to head to that chopper. It draws people to the crash site. It means that you're going to get interaction, you're going to get some fighting, you're going to get squabbling over the gear. It just brings people together and makes DayZ not feel so empty all the fucking time. But we need more dynamic options. How about dynamic ambulance crashes that spawn with medical supplies, dynamic civilian aircraft crashes with food and clothes and civilian guns, dynamic civilian chopper crashes. I mean, there's so many different things that would make the game so much more interesting. I mean, we need crash sites inside forests. We need crash sites all over the place for different things, not just chopper crash sites in the northwest side of the map. But the final thing I want to talk about, I know this is long and rambly, but we'll get there. I came up with a concept in DayZ that I think would be really, really interesting to help looting become an engaging and rewarding process. DayZ looting currently is a simple process. You enter a building or an area, you pick up loot, and you repeat. That's it. This is fine, and with the central loot economy, it means loot spread around in the tiered areas. Again, this is also good, but I just want to get your ideas on this concept. I actually posted this on Reddit, which got a lot of really positive feedback, and I posted it on the DayZ forums, which almost got ignored, but anyway, I guess nobody really reads the DayZ forums. My idea is, what if there were things like locked up compounds and buildings which you couldn't normally get access to? We've already got lots of little compounds all around various different areas with walls or fences in, and all you would have to do is seal these up, stop the kind of fix the gaps in the walls or the fences, and that would make these compounds completely secure. So the twist here is that in order to get into the compound, you would need to find maybe one or two items, like a wire cutter or a bolt cutter, or a very small chance to find some keys to the gate or the doors. That means you could try and get through the fence, or if it's a walled compound, you would need to find a key. So the keys could be found on an infected, perhaps within a few kilometres of the compound, so you'd have to go around and kill infected and try and find the keys in order to get in. The wire cutters could perhaps be, or the bolt cutters could perhaps be a very rare spawn that would happen somewhere in the map. I mean, you could even have things like it could spawn with a scrap of paper indicating where the person who owns the keys or the wire cutters used to work, which means you'd have to travel across the map and try the keys in various compounds around that area. I mean, it sounds like a kind of mod mission, and maybe that's where we could do something like this, but I think in the vanilla game, something like this would add a little bit more depth to the experience of existing here. I know this is a sandbox game, but it doesn't mean it has to be as boring as shit. So with this concept, you could have the central loot economy have a higher chance of spawning higher value items in these areas, these specific little compounds, but you couldn't get in there easily. You'd have to find the keys or the bolt cutters. So we could even have the scenario that a rare ammo crate might spawn somewhere on an airfield, and one of the infected on the airfield would have the key. So you'd have to go around the airfield, hunt down every infected, kill them all, loot all their bodies, get the key, and then go back to find the ammo crate. That would mean that you'd be shooting lots of infected at the airfield instead of just locking them away, which would in turn introduce more interaction. People would hear it, a battle over keys maybe. So many different things could actually happen. So what are your thoughts on a system like this? Is it too much PvE prescriptive aspects for a sandbox game like this? I mean, I think it would be a very rare event for you to find these keys or wire cutters, and it's not really a million miles away from the devs' kind of plans to have the chopper spawns potentially sending out a signal that you would pick up over radios, or do you know, like the new Tizzy idea where it's going to maybe be irradiated zones, you'll need to find a gas mask or a hazard suit to get in. It's not a huge step away from these kind of concepts. So anyway, I think I've rambled on for long enough, so I'm going to wrap up here, and thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care, guys. Thank you.